This message is for the people, by the people. We got a situation. What's up, guys? Big Daddy Sitch is in the building, aka The Situation, and I have a special message for New Jersey, okay? New Jersey is tough. We love to party, and we love even harder, but the time for parties is over. Some of us are not taking this situation seriously. In fact, some of us are prolonging this pandemic by not following simple guidelines. Okay, guys? Be smart and do your part to flatten the curve. Stay home, be positive, and practice social distancing. The comeback is always greater than the setback. We got this, New Jersey.
And that was Mike the Situation Sorrentino doing a PSA on social distancing in New Jersey. Now, Mike is most well known as strolling the boardwalk in New Jersey and being wild on MTV's reality show called The Jersey Shore, which aired years ago. Since then, Mike has done a complete 180. He is now 4 years sober after dealing with addiction. And since then, he has been committed to helping those go through recovery and those who are facing addiction. Mike and his wife, Lauren, are recovery advocates for the Bannon Treatment Centers, and they're joining us today. Mike and Lauren, thank you so much for joining us. Mike, first, why did you decide to do the PSA?
You know what? New Jersey, you know, tapped us on the shoulder, and I was very grateful to be able to participate in such a positive message. And I feel that all Americans right now can do their part and be smart to flatten this curve, and that's including social distancing and staying at home. So when New Jersey asked me, they said that they were having trouble with Corona parties and that the young audience wasn't listening. I stepped up to the plate.
Yeah. Have you heard from officials or anything since you did this PSA, if people have been backing down on having those parties at all?
To be honest with you, I see it everywhere. And I think that is the main purpose of it, you know, for it to be spread and the message to go across to the masses. And I believe it was successful.
Mike and Lauren, I want to talk to you about those who are facing addiction, because we're all home, we're all bored, some of us are out of work, and it's very difficult. And I can imagine it's extremely difficult for those facing addiction. What should they do? What resources can they turn to, especially if they can't go to a meeting?
Yeah, so there are a lot of resources online that are virtually available. Through Zoom meetings, through Skype meetings, through all different applications on the computer or phones. So there's intherooms.com, which is an online meeting group, as well as nabyphone.com. And I really suggest that if you're not willing to get into these new online meetings, to create your own virtual meeting. Everybody has accessibility to these devices, and you can meet your same people virtually that you see on a Tuesday night or a Sunday night, and just get that face-to-face time in, because that is the foundation of your recovery. And if you need to keep that work going, mm-hmm. and not get off that path. And then my husband also has a phone number that's a 24/7 hotline through Bannon Treatment Centers that have tons of resources for everybody in recovery and also people looking for treatment centers and recovery. And you have that number,
yes,
right?
Yes, I do, honey. If you or someone that you know is suffering from the disease of addiction or just looking for recovery resources, please call 1-888-270-5712.
Mike, this may be a time that people are home, and perhaps if they are suffering from addiction, they may say, okay, that's it, I'm getting sober. And they may try and get clean and detox, but that's not a good thing, especially where the hospitals are at right now, right?
Yeah, no, the hospitals are overrun right now. And trying to detox at home, you may end up in the hospital, in the emergency room, okay? And we have partnered with Bannon Treatment Centers. We have 11 facilities that are fully prepped and fully ready for intake. So I would trust the professionals. If you think that you have a problem, please call the number.
And it's a much safer environment. You don't want to be taking up a hospital bed from somebody that has COVID-19. You also don't want to be around the contagion that's going on with that. So just look out for yourself and for everybody else.
All right, Mike and Lauren, we have a few seconds. Any final thoughts and to folks out there who are thinking about maybe going out and going to a party, or those who are suffering from addiction?
Oh, God. I would have to say, guys, please stay home. It saves life. Be smart and be a part of flattening the curve, guys. We all are in this together.
All right, Mike and Lauren, thank you so much. I appreciate everything. And you guys stay safe there in New Jersey. Coming up, we're going to have continuing coverage of the coronavirus out.